Chapter 3, Enemy of the State. Hello and welcome back to part 3 of the Mafia walkthrough. My name is Taylor and welcome back to 2K Central Channel. Hope you're enjoying the walkthrough so far, I'm loving it. It's great, fantastic. Look at the boobies on the wall. Not boobies, it's just a woman. She's got boobies underneath there though. And the phone's ringing. Should I change my clothes first? Oh, that's annoying. So we wore the fabulous clothes in the last chapter. And I don't know what to wear this time. Oh, that phone is annoying. I've got to shut it up. I'll wear the racing suit. I look great in that. The hell, look at this.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama?
That helmet.
I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
That hat makes him look... Go to the Southport docks and see Mr. Pappalardo. That hat makes Vito look like a dildo. A big leather dildo. Okay, how would you feel if I turned the lights off, sir? Okay, I'm gonna close the door. I don't like how you're shouting. Should I get your car from Joe's garage? Because I've got the DLC, I've got tons of good cars. Look at that. Oh yeah, let's take this baby out. It's max speed, top speed, 137 miles per hour. Look at it, I'm in the racing suit and everything. I'm a dildo riding a lunchbox. Oh, I see that. This is what makes the game good. This is like a futuristic car, basically. This car's like from the 50s or something like that, and it's only the 40s. I'm driving around with the fancy the wings on the back. Look at them, and people are looking at me. Oh my god! Look at that guy. He's about to take off. Look at his helmet. Like dildo. He's about to fly space. Break. Okay. His brakes aren't that good. Any time of the day, Grandpa. Is that a Grandpa? Oh, it is a Grandpa. No wonder. Drive slow as hell. Shit. It's a police car. Oh, for God's sake. Let's do the tactic. In the last chapter, we did the how to escape the Mafia police. Let's watch this. Let's watch as this poor guy tries to capture me. So, let's watch. As the lion escapes from his cage and tries to capture the criminal. Right, and time to leave. Bye bye. Look at him. Oh, what a clueless bastard. Kind of feel bad for him. I probably just made him get disciplined in his job. He's probably not getting paid for this week because he just mucked up that car. Right, let's see what I can get max speed at. I'm at 90. I'm at 100. I'm at 110. 120. 100 and... I can't crash, don't crash. 130. Shit. Sorry, I've got my racing suit on, I'm protected. Oh, shit. The handling on this car is much better as well. Better than these crappy 40s cars, anyway. Turning in here. This would be a good place to go drag racing with your friends. Look at this wide open place. City port. That would be good. Is this where I'm going to lug boxes? He's going to make me... How close was that to the wall? Look at that. Amazing. Like a glove. Parked. Like a glove.
Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Oh, yeah. I'm looking for a Mr. Pappalardo.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Pappalardo at your service. You can call me Derek. I remember your dad. Yep. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
Fish drink.
Oh, well.
Well, that was a conversation killer.
Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
They've got boobies on the wall as well.
Follow me.
That's quite good. Follow Steve. Is he going to make me lug boxes? Can I go faster than them? I've got a racing suit on. I could go faster than them. Can I jump down? No. He doesn't have a helmet. You need a helmet to hide your bald head. So I am wearing this helmet. I've got a bald head. So I eat that guy over there has a hat on. You need one too.
Why did load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
Okay, I'm just gonna lift these for as long as it tells me to. I'm not gonna do his crappy work for him. This takes forever. Load the crates onto the truck. I better only have to load the one crate. I don't want to have to load tons of them. Load crate. Oh, I can leave now. the gate's opened. Yeah, I'm out here. See you later. The door's open. Leave when you've had enough. I mean, I've had enough. I cannot be arsed anymore.
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit, nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
That was easy. And by chance, I just so happened to mention Joe's name.
Follow Steve.
He walks slow as shit. Hurry up! Quite jittery as well, look at him. His butt's shaking. That was a swift
one. What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women. They're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is.
Tense. It's tense. It's not really tense. Because I know Joe.
He might not be home. That wouldn't be good.
Sit down.
Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure. War hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them. Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they...
Why is that guy still eating?
Got it. Which is why
he's making
Steve
me hungry.
Ain't doing the job. Right,
he told
Steve?
Me to leave because his steak was
right,
getting
boss.
Cold, but...
Collect at least 150 bucks, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the sea air and meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then.
I
get
guess.
Going.
Okay. So I've got to go. And batter fuck at these folk. Right, which one? This guy first.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe when you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass.
Ugh! Oh, missed! Oh, well that was easy.
Here's your fucking money.
Yeah,
bitch.
You decided to reconsider.
You just paid the dildo, the human dildo.
Hey, pal.
You.
Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time try to pay on time, okay? Thanks.
Oh, pussy. This guy.
Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problem. I
don't
want no problem.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time.
Sure, I don't want no problems. I don't want no problems.
Oh, here we go. This guy's wanting some.
Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Come fight the human dildo.
Look, asshole, I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
Ah, no can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Right, let me kick your arse then. Oh, you missed! I just, left, right, good night. Just dropped to the floor. Come on, Tom. Is he done? Oh. That was unfortunate. When can I kill him? Come on. Some Irish guy in the back just went, kick his arse! I'll kick the Irish guy's arse in a minute. Oh. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
And want to fight the human dildo? Come on then. Okay. Wait, what happens if I talk to him? It says talk to worker.
This guy already paid.
No, he never. I only talked to three guys, not including the big guy that wanted to fight me.
Here's the money, boss man.
He's still eating his steak!
Good job.
Hurry up and finish the steak already.
I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Yeah, right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain. Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
Cheers, Paul.
Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called.
Joe called. He wants you to talk about Freddy's. Drive to Freddy's in Little Italy. Let's start the drag racing again. The human dildo. Oh, I'm doing donuts. Oh, shit. Oh. Okay. The wood, the frosted wood is very slidey. Right, where am I going? Freddy's bar in Little Italy. Little Italy. I'm on my way. I might get some new suits from that clothes shop. I like the suits because I don't want to wear this human dildo stuff for ages. Oh. Okay, now. Wait. So now I've got to work for this guy. That cop car's gonna chase me. Oh no, it's not. Now I've got to work for this guy. I'm his bitch again. I'm just everyone's bitch. But that's how you move up in the mafia. I was watching Making of the Mob, if anyone's ever seen that. That's really good. It shows you Charles Lucky Luciano and how he grew up, started from the bottom, and now he's here. That's a Drake song. But how he started from the bottom and then worked his way up through the mafia and became the head of the Luciano crime family and stuff like that. And he stopped the boss of bosses. He didn't like how there was a boss of bosses, and so he made five different bosses of five different families or something like that, and they were all a commission, and they decided on what happened in the mafia. And that's what Vito is. In fact, for a while, the head of the Luciano crime family was a guy called Vito Genovese. So maybe that's who Vito's based off of. I don't know. But I need to go and speak to Joe. I think it's coming to the end of the chapter soon. Just need to have a word.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. Big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shkadol. Here, shkadol. He's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry. You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
This one's
Where
quite
can
difficult.
We get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I say you.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, I really like this
this mission. No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe.
So, what do you say, Vito?
I think, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you.
I think this is one of the best missions in Mafia 2. This is one of my favorite missions anyway.
This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Okay, good. Drive to Maria Angelo. No, Agnello's. It's not Angelo. I was going to say, because Angelo was the last name of Tommy Angelo, the guy, the main protagonist from Mafia 1. So maybe it could have been a connection, an Easter egg, but it's not. But yeah, this mission is good. I really like this one. When I sneak into the... I don't know. We'll see what it is anyway. He crashed into me! Buffoon! What are you doing? You're going fast. Oh, there's a wall. He crashed into me. I was skidding and I was going to turn. And he turned into that side of the road. Oh. Not the best driver. But let's go to Maria Agnello's. Oh. I'm so sorry. You want to fight? Bitch. Oh shit. I don't think I'm meant to be fighting. Oh my god, this guy's a good fighter. Oh my god! Okay, I know how to kill him. I know, watch this. You know, again, yes! Then I hit him. Wait, here comes a police car. Okay, it's not. of it. I shouldn't be fighting him. I should just, oh, well, you got fucked. I should have just went inside. Oh, no! There's a gang after me! Maria, Maria and Agnello! God.
First.
Okay.
Can't go there with those guys on my tail.
Shit, I can't go. Okay, there we go. This guy's outside waiting for me. Oh, that went so wrong.
Can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're going to be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Well, she didn't need much convincing. She didn't need much convincing to go. Can I go out? No one's going to kill me. Wait, where is she? Hurry up!
Let's go and take it easy behind.
Oh God, dead end! Get it right up, yes!
Alright, kid. The place is locked up.
Oh, the police aren't even off me either.
You gotta get into the bag.
They keep the back door.
That guy got fucked.
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I can go through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you.
I am, I don't know if you noticed, but I'm not the
what
best driver.
What are you doing, you maniac?
Oh, shut up, Maria. No one asked for your opinion.
Hey, Ledfoot, take it easy. My
oh, shut up!
Going nowhere.
Detour.
Kids
okay.
These days.
Well, at least I got you to the hospital.
All right,
safe
kid,
and sound.
Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
That's the
thanks,
office
Maria.
Over there.
I'll see you.
Oh, thank God she's gone. How annoying. Unnecessary. That was a perfect circle, look at that. Office buildings. And I'm going to drive round the site. I think. No, I'm going to go round here, yeah. Okay, round here. Wow, why is Vito so jittery? Vito! Vito, please! Oh, this is going to be good. Look at his outfit. It's amazing. Spandex. I look like Spider-Man. Just a really shit version. Now there's a way. Oh, I should. No, there's a way to do this. Without the alarm going off. And I did know how to do it when I used to play this on the Xbox 360, but I don't know how to do it anymore. So. Kind of annoying, but.
Yeah, I'll believe that when I see it. And I pipe down while I finish my puzzle.
Hopefully no one could see me.
Make the rounds. Good riddance to you.
This guy's gonna drop down dead. How do you kill him stealthily? Stealth kill. Has he got a gun?
Okay, this is the director's office. This is where the key should be.
Office.
All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe.
No worries. Should I bring him with me? You're coming with me. Oh my god. It takes so long. Right, where have I to go? Should I kill that guy? I think I'll kill this guy. Because I don't want to be... I don't want to come out of there. For him to... I just cut off the conversation. It's going to be a bit mysterious. Oh. Alright, so I don't know how to not set off the alarm. But is it in here that you press a button or something like that? I don't know. Let's unlock the door though. Is there a button somewhere? No. Okay. No way to do it, but someone will be seeing this and know how to do it. I don't know. It'll be like the other side of the office or something like that, that the security thing can be turned off, but I don't really want to. The arm has been raised. Leg it! Leg it, boys! Oh, shit. Oh, he's there. Oh, you can't see me. You can't see me.
This is the Empire Bay Police Department. We
How do you get
you
out?
Surrounded. Come out with your hands up.
If How do you get
not
out
surrender immediately, we will open fire.
How'd you get out? Oh, what a nightmare this is. Shit. Oh, shit. He said if I kill anyone that my price goes down, but to be honest, I don't really care. Okay, so I just went around in a circle. I think there's a guy around here. Oh shit! Oh, those reflexes! The turn! The turn is real! I've almost killed everyone in the damn place. One guy left, one poor guy.
Come on, give it up. You ain't got a chance.
Yeah, I don't know where that guy is. Is this how you get out? Is he chasing me? I hope this is how you get out. Is it? No. Is it up here? Oh, it is. I can't sprint either, that's really annoying. Come on, Trigo! Human dildo! I love how that one cop's still in there. I think he's a bit... There he is! He's shooting me! Yeah, he got out fast. That was amazing, he managed to keep up with me. Did a crap job of chasing though. I'm away. Look at this poor guy. Wait. Is he trying to fight me? I don't want to fight. I was going to fight a hobo. Don't crash into me. Oh, he's already crashed. Look, he's lost a light. Maybe I crashed into him. Hello. Oh, my jam is on again. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Look. Ah! Oh. So many close calls. That one wasn't close. The car's almost broken. I need to fix it. How I hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight. Where am I going? Here. Okay. Hey Henry! Oh, he's gonna go mental. I killed everyone in there apart from one guy.
Mom, how'd you make out?
Things got out of hand. There was nothing I could do about it.
We had an agreement. Remember? You only get a third of the money if there's any shooting.
Let's see what we got here.
Damn it.
Ah, shit.
Something wrong?
You bet your ass there's something wrong. These stamps you took have an expiration date. And that date is tomorrow.
So, what exactly does that mean?
It means they're gonna be fucking worthless. But wait. If you can get them to the gas station attendants by midnight, they'll be able to stamp them and redeem them. You better bring them to every gas station in town. They gotta get there by midnight or we're screwed. You don't sell them in time, you get nothing.
Wait a minute, that wasn't our deal. You didn't say anything about any expiration dates.
Well, shit happens, doesn't it?
Look, shit does happen.
Pull this off, I won't forget it, trust me. Now get going. The faster you unload them, the more money you get.
It's all about the money, him. Why is Henry saying all these deals to me? Oh, if you only kill people. If you kill people, you only get a third of the money. Oh, if you deliver all these things, then you get... I don't know. So, I should go to there. No, I should go to there, then there. No, no, I'll go there, 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 there. Okay. I don't know why I placed a waypoint, but I'll just place a waypoint each time, because this actually gets quite hard. But to look how fast the timer's gone down already, and it's only been, what, 30 seconds or something like that. I have 5 minutes to get across the whole map or something. I need to... Lucky I've got a fast car to do it in. Imagine I had that little crappy Joe's car. This would be close to impossible.
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Alright, mate.
Sure. Just keep this between you and me, alright?
No problem.
Yeah, good one, okay. Right, I need to go to the next one.
Just make sure you do the same.
Sure. Sounds good to me.
Good one, good one, good one. Right, I want to make as much money as I can, so I'm gonna floor it. I'm gonna fast and furious. I don't think I have to go to every... Yeah, I don't have to go to every gas station, so I may as well just go to the ones that are nearest me. I only have to, it's one out of six gas stations I have to go to. And so... I'll just go to the ones nearest me. Move, bitch! I'm so sorry. Came flying around the corner and she was like... Oh my god, a futuristic sports car. Driven by a human dildo has been flying in my face. Move! Right. The next gas station. Ah! Almost ran him over.
Hey,
hey, you wanna buy some stamps, bitch?
Some surplus gas stamps? Sure. Where'd you get them? Second thought, I don't even wanna know.
Yeah. Alright, now fork over the dough.
Yeah, alright. Just hope I don't get in trouble for this.
Okay, bye bye.
Just keep your mouth shut.
Oh! He almost got it in the dick. Right, where are we going next? Around here. I'm running low on fuel. Look at the fuel button on the dialer thing. Oh shit, wrong turn. I'm running low. I need to... I don't think I have time to fill up on fuel. Which is really annoying. Imagine this car runs out of fuel, that's the worst thing that could happen. I'm not failing this mission. I'm going to try and go through this game without dying. Like I said in the first chapter, I was playing this on medium. I'm playing this on medium difficulty. Just for, I don't know, for the sake of it, so I don't die much. Because it's just a walkthrough, there's no point in dying all the time. I'm not a bitch, I've played this on hard many times. I've got nothing to prove. Who are you? Hey, you've never played on hard.
I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Where now? Where's nearest? There.
Yeah, yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Walk over the dough.
Sure, sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me.
Very good. Hey, where to next? Around here. I'm gonna need to go through the underground bridge? You're running out of fuel. You can find the nearest gas station on your map. Okay, I'm gonna have to refuel when I get to this next. What the fuck are you doing? Ah! What the fuck is going on? Okay. I've regained control. Wow. I'm really not good at driving. I think it's the snow. The snow makes it worse. Although I did say that I really like the snow. Oh god. Alright, so I need to get to this gas station and fill up. Where else? I thought I ran out of fuel there for some reason. Something. I don't know what happened, but it's like the engine cut out or something like that. I'll refuel at this. Don't turn. Don't offer fucks. Redeemed. I'll refuel at this next gas station. If the police car doesn't hit me. That police car hit me there. Even though I was the one that cut through the middle. Oopsie. Wasn't my fault. How far away is this gas station? Shit. I'm gonna get done for speeding. Yeah. Oh my god. No!
Some idiot just drove into us. We're bringing him in.
No!
10-4.
No! Run! No! Oh, I'm so screwed. I am so screwed. Okay, I'm gonna have to hide behind one of these cars. Okay, I got away. I need to get into this one though. This is gonna be slow shit! That failed so badly. Oh, I can't get over how badly that failed. Look how slow this damn car is! Oh no. I've failed the mission. Halfway to midnight, I know! There's no way I'm gonna complete this. Actually, I might. I've done it on hard before, and that's really difficult on hard. Right, where am I closest to? I could go all the way down there. And there. Yeah, okay.
Airstapes. You want them, they're yours. Cheap.
Yeah, all right. I'm good with that.
All right, here you go. You keep your mouth shut.
Oh my god.
This, all right?
Sure thing, buddy. It'll be our secret.
It better be.
It takes forever. You visit 4 to 6 gas stations. Right, so I'll just go those next two across the tunnel. If the car gets here, if the car moves on time. It takes an age. Look at it. Now this is the definition of a lunchbox. Look at it. The driving gives me a heart attack too much. Right, what better radio stations are there than this? Radio off. Delta radio. Oh, for fuck's sake. Delta radio. Empire Classic. Quite like that one. I think Dean Martin's on this one. Dean Martin's on the Empire Classic radio. Sounds like I've got Tourette's with how often I'm screaming from driving while I'm talking. I'll be talking and then yeah, all the time. Like Jimmy from South Park. What song's this? Not Good Enough is what it is. There's a barn. Right, no car getting my way. Yep, it's the underground tunnel. See, it's not snowy in here, so it's easy to drive. It's harder to drive on the other ones. On the other non-snow vehicles. Oh, what the fuck, you bastard! You evil man! Oh, look, he's crashed. He turned out in front of me. That's what he gets. Oh, for God's sake, that's the thing right there. Why are you hitting into me? Okay. This is how you get rid of the police. Hi, right? What the hell are you doing? What? Stop! Okay, I've stopped. Get out of your car. Oh, he's after someone else! Okay. This is weird. I'll just be going over here to sell the gas stamps.
Hey, interested in buying some gas stamps?
Sure.
I need to get to the last one on time, which I will, but...
Just keep this between you and me, alright?
No, look at that cop! He arrested sure, some other guy. Sure. He was meant to arrest me and he didn't. He just turned around and... Oh, poor unlucky guy. I got scot-free. Empire State Building. Empire Bay. Bay. What a shame. But, hopefully I don't get stuck by the cop. I will make it, I think. Which is a miracle. In this lunchbox. Who thinks I'm... Look at it. That is one good thing. I like the snow of this, but I like the, I like when it turns to the 50s in this game. And the snow disappears. Quite good. Hopefully there's stuff like that in Mafia 3, like weather changes and condition changes and stuff like that. That would be good if it changed from winter. Although, no, actually, no, I don't think so, because it's Mafia 3 set in Louisiana, and Louisiana's a hot place. So I hope it is. I think it is. I'll be very embarrassed if I'm wrong. I don't think I am though.
Hey, I got some extra gas stamps. Interested?
Yeah, sure. I'm interested.
All right, here you go. Walk over to dough.
Sure. Here's your money.
Thanks, pal. Now forget you saw me. All right, that's the last of them. At least I got some cash.
Good. At least I got some cash. Should head back to Joe's. Why is it telling me to go behind? Why can't I go this way? Oh yeah, because it... Oh wait, well, I may as well just go this way now. It's gonna take me back up the road. Oh shit. Oh, the police never came after me. I thought the police were gonna come after me. That's quite good. But that was easy. If you've ever played this game on hard, those gas stamps are quite difficult, especially if you don't have any DLC, because then, oh, wrong way. Especially if you don't have any DLC, because you can't get any fast cars. And, yeah, imagine if you try and do this on hard in this car. I did it in the slowest car I completed in was the DLC, the war DLC, and it was the war Jeep thing. But then again, that was still DLC, and that car's a wee bit fast. But not really fast. Whereas that sports car I had that broke down, that was fast. And that reaches, what, 140 in about 20 seconds? This reaches a max of about 80 in, what, a minute? It takes ages. But, yeah, if you're going to do that mission on hard, I really think you should do it on... And I really think you should pay, I think it's £1.69 or something, like $3 for... one DLC pack, and if it is, I forgot what DLC pack it is. I don't know if it's the Vegas DLC pack or if it's the Greaser DLC pack. The Greaser DLC pack gives you the hot rods, I think. I'm not sure about the... It might be the Vegas. I think it is. It's the Vegas one. The Vegas pack that gives you that lowdown blue sports car that I had. Oh, fuck! How did I not die? I'm invincible. That was amazing. But for people say that this map is small, and it is small compared to other games. At the same time this game came out, Just Cause 2 came out, and that map was unbelievably huge. It's bigger than Grand Theft Auto 5. That was 2010, so people were comparing it to things like that. And I guess if you compare it to things like that, it's going to be small, but when you actually think of this game individually, and you think of this game on its own, the map's actually quite big. Look, it took me quite a while to get from just across the bridge to, or just across the tunnel to Joe's place here. It took quite a while. But, yeah, the human dildo. That is the end of the human dildo. It's also the end of this chapter and the video. If you enjoyed the video, then make sure you subscribe to 2K Central, and also leave a like on this video. Yeah, it helps out, I think. The channel's brand new, the walkthrough's brand new, but yeah, my name's Taylor. I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next chapter of this walkthrough. Ooh, the outro. I bet you like outros. I like outros. Maybe not as much as the main video though, but outros are still good. It tells you what the previous video was, it tells you what a random video is. Maybe you don't have to click anything at all. I'm surprised you even made it this far. Okay, I'm really gonna go now. Bye-bye.